All right, so I just started draining my angel tank. It has four of my baby angels in it and about, I don't know, I'm guessing 20 big mystery snails. And there's two cory cats in it. So, water change Wednesday. Welcome, everybody.
Yep.
Naja's guadalupensis, also known as guppy grass. And there's some red myrio in there, and I'm trying to work pearl weed into every tank I have because it's amazing. I got a little tiny bunch, like a little tiny piece of, well, probably about that much from LRB, and I now have it in all my tanks because I just keep growing it and growing it and growing it. Oh, there's poppy down on the bottom over there. All right, I'm going to check the temperature on this. Which seems about right. Usually about 1 or 2 degrees under. I mean, under what it just said. You know what I mean? It's like 81. I match it up. So I just switched it over, so it's pumping water back in. I made this little thing, it's easy. I'm pretty sure I stole it off of somebody else online, I have no idea who. But just a couple pieces of PVC and your Python added to it with the sponge filter. Drill some holes in it, add a little bit of prime. My water has ammonia. Or chlorine, not ammonia. But chlorine is a chloramine, so it's about as harmful as chlorine or ammonia. It's not good. So use that to take it out until I put in the right filter. Pre-filter. All these tanks are nothing but sponge filter and a bunch of substrate. And lots of plants. Oh yeah, I don't think the angels are going to come out. They usually get all tested when I change them. But Poppy's out. He's my beta. Crown tail, pretty happy. All right, I got to go shut off this water on the other tank. So it's all the way full. I'm gonna go ahead and move it over. Most people may quarantine a lot of their stuff, but I haven't had any sick fish. So I will just continue to move this over tank to tank to tank and water change all of them. And I do this twice a week. So 50%, oops. Come on, buddy. There you go. She came off. I've been perfect. Poppy's gonna like pout after we do this, but it's funny. All right, gonna go ahead and turn the water off. So this is pretty much just a wash, hair, rinse, repeat. Sticking in one tank, sticking in the other, check the temperature, and I usually shoot for the top of the sponge filter. That way I'm not getting a bunch of reflection. Oh, the tank that Poppy's in also has like 9 or 10, camera in on it a little bit, 9 or 10 panda corys that are still babies. They may come out. We'll leave it there for a minute. Yeah, Poppy's resting on the sponge filter. That's crazy. This is really the easiest way for me to do water changes. I couldn't imagine using buckets. I have a sink. It's like 20 feet away from here. Oops. Fingers. Yeah, there's 4 tanks on the stand. The air filter over there, or air pump. Use it for all the sponge filters. I'm going to take a temperature check. Probably really about 80, which I like to keep it up a little bit. I don't like low temperatures for some of the fish that are subject to ick and like bettas. I'd rather keep them a little warmer. They're more active, at least for me. Alright, so I matched the temperature, and now I'm going to add a little bit more prime. Hopefully the pandas will come out. Move the next tank, which is my mutt guppy tank, which really aren't all mutts. They're really awesome fish. I've had so many guppies that, and hybrids and everything else, that I had to kind of put them in together for a little bit. There's also some light blue mystery snails in there. So I'm hoping that they mate, or mate with one of my chestnuts, and I get a lot more snails, because snails are pretty dang cool for cleaning stuff. And yeah, I sound like I'm from Ohio. The Poppy's pretty happy up there. Dang. There he is. I'm going to go shut this off here in a sec. Thank you. This tank actually has an Imperial Ranger pleco in it. They're really cool. They'll get about 8-9 inches long. So this is not his forever tank, but he's growing up in here. They have white tails, like a white line on their rear tail. I don't see him out at the moment, but he's a gorgeous fish. Pretty ram's horns in here. And some really big mysteries. This is one of the final tanks that I move them up through. They all get fed green beans or broccoli or carrots. I found out they all love. Who knew? Even the guppies were eating them. Yeah. Alright, gotta check the temp. This one's 81. Guppies I keep cooler. Yeah, some of these guppies are bad. Little flame tail type. Yeah, there's the little flame tail. Yeah, he's actually showing off there. There's a couple of them in there. So I'm gonna try and line bring those out. Water's about full. Gotta go shut it off again and remove tanks again. that one's cool. Move to the little 10-gallon over here, which is full of LRB. Oops. These are all Blue Star endlers, a pure strain, not mixed. They're clean as the day I got them. I kept them in two strains after they got big enough and moved one back to help the genetics. That's about it. Plus, I've sold them to a bunch of people, and if I ever need the genes, I can get them. But really cool little fish. Don't think it'll really. Well, there we go. Their coloration makes it look like they have a single tail, but the top tail is actually just clear. So it's like a false higher tail, I guess. I don't know, they're really cool fish, though. You get the black bars and. Well, black body with blue, and it's almost a purple neon color, blue neon. Really cool. So, on to that one. This one does not take very long to train at all. So it's sitting underneath a AgriBright T5 bulb setup. With my 54 punchy sticker on there. And I got these for shades when I want to throw down white. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and temperature this. This one's usually cold. Switched it over. Had a really small amount of prime. Now normally, like every 2 weeks, I'll clean the mulm out of the bottom of this tank because it is there's no substrate at all on it. Just all plants. So that's why I didn't actually use any vacuums tonight. I don't use a vacuum on any of the tanks except for this one. Or if something really is bad in the tank. Whoops. Alright, so I'm going to shut this off and move this over to this other tank, which has a bunch of what I call some of my baby angels, but he's huge. He keeps eating all these guppy babies, and there's a bunch of Cendontis eruptus catfish in here. Just four of them. All right, I'm gonna get off here for now.